Jane Piper is an Australian violinist, in fact, the only Australian in the orchestra. She's in the second violin group and realised that during her study years that playing the second violin was really her calling. That's right, isn't it, Jane? I mean, you have no ambitions to be a first violinist.
This may come as a shock, but I was never a great virtuoso, Dominic. But in university, I formed a string quartet with some very dear friends, and I played second violin in the string quartet, and it was a very formative experience, let's say.
And what is it about playing second violin that that became so attractive to you?
If you want to know what's so great about second violin, in your next life, do not learn the double bass, learn the violin, and get good enough so you can play the second violin part of a Mozart opera, and you will never look back. It's got it all, I promise you.
Okay. Yeah. Great. Well, I shall do that in my next life. So you studied in Australia, came over to Amsterdam. That's a very long way. I mean, Australia is a very long way from everywhere.
Yes, it's true. I cannot go home for the weekend, unfortunately.
Right. Yeah. What brought you over to Amsterdam?
Well, after I'd finished studying in Sydney, I was freelancing and I was touring quite a lot, and one of these tours finished off in New York, and I decided I was going to stay. I wanted to have an adventure, I suppose, and I sublet an apartment for some weeks, and I'd heard about this guru teacher in New York, and I stayed and I started having some lessons and had a great time, but then the inevitable happened and I started to run out of money pretty fast. And at the time, my sister was living in London and I had just enough frequent flight points to get to London. Got to London, slept on the floor of her apartment, and I saw this advertisement for an orchestra in Amsterdam. I knew nothing about the Netherlands. And it was a 50% job in the Netherlands Chamber Orchestra, and it was a conductorless orchestra, and I applied. I had 4 really lovely days here, practising like crazy, of course, but also just discovering this wonderful city. I went to the museums and wandered around the canals, and yeah, it was quite bizarre. And then
You got the job.
Yeah.
And you moved to Amsterdam. And the difference then between Australia and Amsterdam, what was the biggest difference?
Well, so after that audition, I actually went back to Australia for summer, the last great summer I've ever had. And moved then in the middle of January to Amsterdam. And yeah, I mean, I'd never had central heating before. I think I was freezing. And it took me about 3 weeks to defrost.
Wow, because of course January in Australia, that's super hot. Whereabouts in Australia were you?
Sydney.
In Sydney.
It's a very nice climate.
Okay, yeah, it is indeed. Do you miss Australia? I mean, how Australian do you feel?
I mean, the great thing about Amsterdam, one of the reasons I've stayed so long, is because I've always felt here like you can retain your sense of identity. I feel like you can be who you are here.
And anything specific that you miss apart from friends and family from the Vegemite?
No, not really. No. You can get Vegemite here. The world is a lot smaller than it used to be, so yeah. Vegemite, no problem.
Now, you and my wife have something in common.
Right.
You're very, very lucky, both of you, because you're married to British bass players.
Oh, yes. I'm married to the funny one, but yeah.
And the one that actually can play the bass really well.
Yeah.
Matthew, who's a dear colleague, but he's solo bass in the Rotterdam Philharmonic Orchestra, but has often played with us. How is it when you've got two people that have got full-time orchestral jobs but different orchestras? How does that work in the house? What are the upsides of that and what are the downsides?
Well, the upside is, I guess, that there's an understanding of, but then at the same time, we're not in the same orchestra. That's also sometimes maybe an advantage.
And what's the downside of living with an amazing British bass player? I can't think that there can be any, can there?
I'm sure you can't think of any. I don't know if your wife suffers the same thing, but when I walk in the front door, I trip over the double bass because we have 3 double basses in the house. And they're very large instruments.
What's even worse, but what's even worse is that when you take the case off, it then takes up double the amount of space.
Exactly.
Because the case is just as
big as... Where do you keep
a
double bass case? That is the question I'm trying to answer for years.
Wonderful. It's fantastic to have you as a colleague in the orchestra. You're always a fantastic sense of humour, and it's nice to be able to often just speak fluent English with somebody, so I appreciate, and somebody that understands bass players, so I appreciate you very, very much.
Thanks so much.
Thank you so much for speaking
to
me.
Thank you.